بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب ربنا إنك جامع الناس ليوم لا ريب فيه إن الله لا يخلف الميعاد أفضل الذكر لا إله إلا الله وأفضل الدعاء الحمد لله وأفضل العبادة اتباع السنة علامة الإخلاص أيها الأحبة أن تشك في إخلاصك علامة الإخلاص أن تشك في إخلاصك والسعادة ليست حلماً ولا وهماً ولا بمحال ولكن السعادة في التفاؤل وحسن الظن بالله سبحانه وتعالى والصبر من غير استعجال. My dear brothers and sisters, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep us on the straight path. This is the dua of the scholars. In Surah Ali Imran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke about الراسخون في العلم, those who are endowed with knowledge. That is their dua immediately. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا. Which tells you, just because you are guided, don't feel that you are secured and you got it made. You can be so righteous and fall. We know what happened at the time of Prophet Musa alayhi salam, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke about a knowledgeable person who fell after all that knowledge that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him for just mere some benefit from this world. وَاتْلُ عَلَيْهِمْ نَبَأَ الَّذِي آتَيْنَاهُ آيَاتِنَا فَانْسَلَخَ مِنْهَا فَأَتْبَعَهُ الشَّيْطَانُ فَكَانَ مِنَ الْغَاوِينَ وَلَوْ شِئْنَا لَرَفَعْنَاهُ بِهَا وَلَكِنَّهُ أَخْلَدَ إِلَى الْأَرْضِ وَاتَّبَعَ هَوَاهُ. The ayat, the knowledge that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave that person, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, these ayat, it's supposed to elevate him. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala could have elevated him. But because he looked in his heart and he saw that he doesn't deserve that, أَخْلَدَ إِلَى الْأَرْضِ, he is attached to this life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala set an example for him, called him Kalb. He is like a dog. So just because a person sees himself, mashallah, things are going good, you are fasting and you're praying and you're jama'ah and you're seeking knowledge and people love you and everything is going right for you, and you just put one leg over the other and you say you got it made. وَاعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ يَحُولُ بَيْنَ الْمَرْءِ وَقَلْبِهِ وَأَنَّهُ إِلَيْهِ تُحْشَرُونَ. Know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala holding your heart between His fingers. He turns it any way He will. And subhanahu wa ta'ala turns it according to what He knows about you. So you may think of yourself highly, and in reality you're not. That's why we said, the sign of sincerity is to doubt your sincerity. When the companion radiallahu anhu came to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Hamdala radiallahu anhu, he said, Nafaqa Hamdala. Hamdala is committing hypocrisy. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, what is it? He said, when I'm with you, O Prophet of Allah, my faith is way up there. I feel like for sure I'm going to heaven. And then when I leave you, and I go to my wife, and I go to the children, I go to work, I'm not like that. So it looks like I'm being hypocrite, looking good in front of you and not looking good when I leave you. This feeling by itself tells you the sincerity of Hamdallah radiallahu anhu. Just to feel that you are not sincere is a sign of sincerity. When you doubt yourself, what does that do to you? For a knowledgeable person, it makes him work more. It makes him belittle the big deed that he does and think of the little sin as a huge thing. That is for the knowledgeable person. For a non-knowledgeable person, he would tell you, oh, come on, you're ruining our life. Every time you do something, you keep thinking that we are not sincere. Of course we are sincere. Why do you think we're doing it? Why do you think I came to the masjid? Why do you think I left my house? That's scary. That's really scary when someone, but then again, when you don't have the knowledge, you would say that. But when you have knowledge, yes, you leave your wife and you leave your children and you drive and you leave the fun time and you come to the masjid and you still don't know if you are sincere or not. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows. Something might pop in your head that you want to see someone or you're going to miss something or whatever it is. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows that. Sa'ada, happiness, it's not an imaginary thing or a dream or something that you cannot reach. Sa'ada is to be optimistic. Sa'ada is to think good of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sa'ada is when difficulty strikes you, you look and you say, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is there. Inna Allaha ma'ana. Inna Allaha ma'ana. That's what Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam told Abu Bakr as-Siddiq in the worst situations. Look, husnul dhan billah. He's thinking so highly of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. At time, death is imminent. Definitely, you're going to die. I mean, they're standing on top of the mouth of the ghar, the cave, and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam saying, "Don't worry, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with us." Look at the trust, look at the optimism, look at the confidence that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam had. Also, happiness is when you are patient. When you're patient on whatever situations you fall in. When you don't rush the solutions. It's not like I have the problem now, boom, I'm going to get the solution right away. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam made a dua, he received the answer 8 years after, 8 or 15 years after. Look at Prophet Nuh alayhi salam when he received the answer from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to build you. Calamities and problems build the person, makes you a real man. Because you go through it. How can you be a leader if you've never been there? How can tell people to be patient if you're never patient? How can tell people persevere and calamities are, and you've never been stricken with a calamity? How can you feel with people who never got hurt? Look at the children, the first time they hurt, what happens? The screaming, the crying, left and right, because they never felt that pain before. But then after that, it gets easier and easier because they've been there. And that's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does when He tests you. أَمْ حَسِبْتُمْ أَن تَدْخُلُوا الْجَنَّةِ. You think Jannah is just like لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله تفضل ادخل. وَلَمَّا يَأْتِكُمْ مَثَلُ الَّذِينَ خَلَوْا مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ مَسَّتْهُمُ الْبَأْسَاءُ وَالضَّرَّاءُ وَزُلْزِلُوا. You have to go through the path that everyone else did. All the prophets and all the righteous people, they have been stricken with poverty. They have been stricken with calamities, with diseases, with sickness, with fear, everything. وَزُلْزِلُوا. They were shaken until they give up hope in everything and they think that's it. Without Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we're doomed. Boom! At that time, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives the victory. أَلَا إِنَّ نَصْرَ اللَّهِ قَرِيبٌ. Now, you're supposed to do that from the beginning. But since you did not, because you were relying on your power, you're relying on your strength, you're relying on your mind, you're relying on your faith. But little reliance on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tested you with everything until you gave up hope in everything. And unfortunately, this is what we do all the time. We try everything, and then when we fail, we go, okay, brother, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, if you read Al-Fatiha, it's a healing, right? Yeah, it's right. Okay, read on me. Did you go to the doctor? Yes, yeah. Did you try? Yeah, nothing worked. Now we'll try Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, see if that works. Where it's supposed to be, number one, you go to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before anyone else. And then you seek other things. Brothers and sisters, عامل الناس بما ترى وليس بما تسمع. Deal with people with what you see, not what you hear. Even what you see, a lot of it is not real. You know what I mean. I can look at the person, and he looks so righteous. وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يُعْجِبُكَ قَوْلُهُ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَيُشْهِدُ اللَّهَ عَلَى مَا فِي قَلْبِهِ وَهُوَ أَلَدُّ الْخِصَامِ. Some people, they look so wonderful, and they speak so wonderful, and he swears and promises and tells you, I am, and I will, and I will. And in reality, he is mortal enemy to you. So what you see, even doubt that. Isa alayhi salam saw a person stealing, and he told him, why you steal? He said, wallahi, I didn't. He said, I believe you and I disbelieve my eyes. How can someone swear in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's name lying? So he said, the problem with my vision. He swore. So the problem with my vision, not with what he said. This is how you hold Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in high status. This is how you value the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is how when you talk about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you don't just go, Allah said then, Allah said then, Allah said then. It sounds like you're talking about your friend or about someone down the street. Where is the ijlal? Where is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when he said, سَبِّحُوهُ عَظِّمُوهُ تَعْظِيمِ اللَّهِ إِجْلَالِ اللَّهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى. So brothers and sisters, a Muslim inhales or supposed to inhale the good and exhale the bad. Imam al-Shafi'i, when he used to sit with the Mu'tazila, and you shouldn't be sitting in circles of people who deny the names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and say things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not say, you're not supposed to sit. But Imam Shafi'i rahimahullah is scholar, knowledgeable. He knows the right and the wrong. You may have so many benefit, I can benefit from you, and you have something bad. I know what's bad, I'll avoid it. I'll take advantage of the good thing you have. When you have someone who uses logic and he can prove and he can argue, and you know the majority of the people are like that, I want to learn that. Because I'm dealing with people, I need to convince people, so I need to sit with people who are good with that, and they were good. When people blamed him, he said, I take the good from them and I throw the bad back at them. This is for a knowledgeable person. Not for someone like coming from here. He doesn't know how to read Al-Fatiha. Then he tells you, Shaykh, you know, Alhamdulillah, I'm reading the Bible because I'm talking to the people at work. And now you're reading the Bible? Go read the Quran, ya Habibi. Understand your Quran before you try to read the Bible and convince people with the Bible. How can you forget the basis and you go in for something else? So brothers and sisters, inhale the good and exhale the bad. And كما قال داود الطائي كفى بالعلم عبادة. You want to really worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? That's what you're doing. That's the biggest worship you can do after the obligations, is to sit and listen and learn about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. لم نخلق أيها الأحبة إلا لغاية. We're not created in vain. We're created for a purpose. And this is something that makes you more serious. When you know why you're here, and